Dear students, this is my second lecture for chapter Amalgamation in subject Advanced Accounting and Auditing Paper 2 for class second year BCom semester 3 V Nirmit South Gujarat University. In this particular lecture we will discuss the difference between merger and purchase. Second, methods of accounting for amalgamation. First method, pooling of interest method. And accounting entries by transferee company, that is amalgamated company, using pooling of interest method. First of all, let us see the difference between merger and purchase. The first point of difference, the business of the transferor company, that is amalgamating company, old existing company, is intended to be continued by the transferee company, that is amalgamated company or a new company. Whereas in purchase, the business of transferor company may not intended to be continued by the transferee company. It means in case of merger, the business of old companies which are going to liquidate shall be continued by the transferee company. Whereas in the case of purchase, the business of old companies will not be continued by the transferee company. Second point of difference, all the assets, liabilities, capital and reserves represents the sum of the relevant figures of the amalgamating companies. And in case of purchase, assets and liabilities may not be taken up in full by the transferee company in total. In effect, there is no pooling of assets and liabilities. It means in case of merger, all assets, liabilities, capital and reserves are taken over by the amalgamated companies. Whereas in case of purchase, assets and liabilities may not be taken up in full by the transferee company. Next point of difference, there is a continuing participation by the management of the transferor company in the management of the transferor company after amalgamation. In case of purchase, the transferee company takes the role of a dominant party after the amalgamation. That means in case of merger, the management of old company continues in the management of the transferor company after amalgamation. Whereas in case of purchase, the management of transferee company takes the dominant party role after the amalgamation. Point number 4, the pooling of interest method of accounting is generally used in case of merger. Whereas in case of purchase, the purchase method of accounting is normally used for amalgamation. So these were the points of difference between merger and purchase. Now we will see the methods of accounting for amalgamation. Methods of accounting for amalgamation in case of merger. First, pooling of interest method. We use pooling of interest method for accounting the amalgamation transactions in case of merger. This method of accounting is applicable for amalgamation in the nature of merger. That means pooling of interest method is used for amalgamation in the nature of merger. As per this method, all assets, liabilities and reserves, whether capital or revenue or arising on revaluation of the transferor company, are recorded at their existing carrying amounts and in the same form as at the date of amalgamation by the transferor company. It means All assets, liabilities and reserves are taken over by the new company at its existing value and in the same form by the amalgamated company, that is new company or a transferor company. Further, the balance of profit and loss account of the transferor company are aggregated with the corresponding balance of the transferee company or transfer to general reserve, if any. Then finally, it reflects that the entries are simply merged together, and as a result, no goodwill account should be accounted for in merger. So, dear students, this is pooling of interest method for accounting the transactions of amalgamation in case of merger. Now we will see the various accounting transactions journal entry to be passed by new company, that is transferee company, in their books. Journal entries in the books of transferee company in case of merger. First transaction, for consideration for amalgamation become due, and our accounting entry, business merger account debit to liquidator of transferor company account with the amount of purchase consideration. Second entry, A, for taking over assets, liabilities and reserves of the transferor company and incorporated in the books of transferee company. Our accounting entry, sundry assets account debit at its book value. Capital loss on merger account debit, this is nothing but the balancing figure, to sundry liabilities account book value, to sundry provisions account book value, to statutory reserves account at book value, to general reserve at book value, to other reserves at its book value, to profit and loss account at its book value, and to capital reserve account, that's a balancing figure. Dear students, here you people understand either capital loss or capital profit. Any one of these two may appear at the time. So, first entry is for acquisition of business, that is merger of business. And the second entry is for transfer of assets, liabilities and reserve of transferor company to the transferee company. Next transaction, 2B, for writing off the capital loss, if any, arising due to merger. And our accounting entry is capital reserve account debit, general reserve account debit, profit and loss account debit to capital loss on merger account. Dear students, as we have seen in the second A, entry capital loss on merger account was debited. Now in 2B, we are crediting the capital loss on merger account, so account will be closed, and that's why it is said writing off the capital loss account, and it is written off against balance of capital reserve, general reserve and profit and loss account. Our next accounting entry is for discharge of consideration of amalgamation. This will be paid by transferee company to transferor company, that is by new company to the old company. And our accounting entry is liquidator of transferee company account debit to equity share capital account, to preference share capital account, to securities premium account and to bank account. Dear students, as we have seen in very first entry, liquidator of transferor company was credited. So, while making payment of purchase consideration, liquidator account will be debited, and whatsoever securities or a cash given as a consideration by transferee company will be credited. So, here our accounting entry, liquidator's account debit to equity share capital account, to preference share capital account, to securities premium account and to bank account. Next, transaction number 4, for liquidation expenses. Dear students, there are various scenarios for liquidation expenses. Let us check one by one all. Scenario number one, that is A. If liquidation expenses are borne by the transferor company itself, that is by old company, so in the books of transferee company, no entry will be passed. Then, second scenario, if liquidation expenses are borne by the transferee company and directly paid by it, then following entry is passed. So our accounting entry will be general reserve or profit and loss account or surplus account debit to cash and bank account. Dear students, here the liquidation expense of old company is paid by the transferee company, that is new company, and because of this payment of liquidation expenses, profit of the new company decreases. Profit at the time of amalgamation is in the form of general reserve, profit and loss or a surplus, and that is why general reserve account or profit and loss account or surplus account is debited and payment made in cash or bank, so cash and bank account is credited. Scenario number 3, if liquidation expenses are borne by transferee company but first paid by the transferor company and then reimbursed by the transferee company, then our accounting entry will be same as accounting entry number 2, that is B, general reserve, profit and loss or surplus account debit to cash or bank account. Next, transaction number 5, for immediate discharge of liabilities, that is debentures, assumed to be taken over. So our accounting entry is debentures of transferor company account debit, discount on issue of debentures account debit, if any, to debentures account, to securities premium account, if any. Here, the transferee company is giving its new debentures for the debentures of a transferor company. And our accounting entry, transferor company debentures account debit, discount on issue of debentures account. Dear students, here discount on issue of debentures account represent the discount of new debentures that is to be issued, and to securities premium account represents the securities premium of new debentures to be issued. Next, B, similar entry is passed for immediate discharge of any other liability assumed to be taken over. This 5A specifically passed for repayment to debenture holders. It can be for any other liabilities similar to the debentures like bank loan, creditors, etc. Next, 5C. If there is a difference between the book value of debentures, book value of debentures and issue price of new debentures, it will be adjusted as under. And It may be a loss. So loss will be written off against capital reserve account debit, general reserve account debit, profit and loss account debit to capital loss on merger account. Dear students, here there are the possibilities that book value of debentures are less than the issue price of new debentures. In that case, there will be a loss to the transferee company, and loss will be considered as a capital loss on merger, and this loss will be written off against capital reserve, general reserve or profit and loss account. And 5D, similar entry will be passed for discharge of any other liabilities, loss or profit on merger account. Next, transaction number 6, for treatment of statutory reserves. Dear students, this is one of the very very important points in chapter for amalgamation in the nature of merger. As per accounting standard 14, it states that certain reserves might have been created by the transferor company pursuant to the requirement of or to avail the benefits of Income Tax Act 1961 or any other act in existence. Say for example, T development allowance reserve, investment allowance reserve, exports profit reserve, foreign projects reserve, site restoration reserve, etc. These are nothing but considered as a statutory reserves because these are needed as per the Income Tax Act 1961. The Act requires that the identity of the statutory reserve should be preserved for a specified period. It can be for a period of 2 years, period of 5 years, etc. And therefore, there is no need of passing separate entry for a statutory reserves. And these statutory reserves are recorded at the time of recording of assets and liabilities as per entry number 2. So, dear students, statutory reserves of amalgamating company will be recorded in the new company as it is because it is requirement of Income Tax Act 1961. So, no entry will be passed for that. It will be considered at the time of passing entries of assets and liabilities taken over. You can check entry number 2. Now, next transaction is for formation expense of the transferee company, and our accounting entry is preliminary expenses account debit to bank account. Here are the formation expenses paid by transferee company, and that is why it is recorded as a preliminary expenses, and our entry is preliminary expenses account debit to bank account. Dear students, here I complete this method, pooling of interest method for amalgamation in the nature of merger. Dear students, first of all, you try to understand the method. Write method in your notebook along with journal entries of various transactions because it is very important for solving the example. Very soon we will meet with the second method, purchase method, for amalgamation in the nature of purchase. Thank you very much.